StarGenetics video tutorial number 1, getting started with StarGenetics. StarGenetics is an educational software tool that allows students to perform virtual genetics experiments. StarGenetics can be used for in-class demonstrations, virtual labs, or homework exercises to explore basic and complex genetic concepts. In this video, we will review the different visualizers or organisms available in StarGenetics for experimentation, how to download the StarGenetics program, and how to open files in StarGenetics. StarGenetics offers different visualizers to allow you to perform experiments in a variety of organisms. These include classic genetics model organisms, such as budding yeast, fruit flies, and Gregor Mendel's garden peas, as well as other non-model organisms, such as fish and cows. Using StarGenetics, you can even perform genetic crosses between smiley faces. Although this introductory video and others will focus on the functionality of the fly visualizer, experiments in the peas, fish, cow, and smiley face visualizers are performed in the same manner. Specific details for each visualizer can be found in the StarGenetics user guide, accessible on the StarGenetics website. Another set of video tutorials available within the website walks you through how to use and perform experiments in the yeast visualizer. To download StarGenetics, navigate to star.mit.edu/genetics. On the homepage, click on the green Start button. The StarGenetics Java application should automatically download onto your computer. If it does not, you can click the link here to download the application. In order to run StarGenetics, you will need to have Java installed on your computer. If you don't already have Java on your computer, you can download it by clicking on the link here. When I download the StarGenetics file in Chrome, which is the internet browser I'm currently using, a question comes up asking if I want to keep the file or discard it. I am going to click Keep, and then open the file that was just downloaded. When you open the StarGenetics file you have just downloaded, a pop-up window will ask whether you allow StarGenetics to access your computer. Click Allow to open the program. Other browsers may ask whether you wish to open or save the JNLP file. If so, click Open with Java Web Start Launcher. Click Allow to open the program. We recommend always starting StarGenetics from the STAR website to ensure you are using the most up-to-date version. But you can also choose to download the application onto your computer for later use in a form that does not require an internet connection to run. This may be necessary if you have limited internet connectivity. To do this, navigate to the StarGenetics website and click on the download link in the menu on the left. Then you can select the file to download, depending on your operating system. Further instructions are included on the download page on the website. We are now going to open a StarGenetics exercise. There are two ways to do this. You can open an exercise that comes bundled with the StarGenetics software, or you can open an exercise that was created by your instructor and downloaded onto your computer. To open an exercise that comes bundled with StarGenetics, on the main menu, click on File, then New. A window will then open with a list of the bundled exercises. Within this window, exercises are organized by organism. The associated documentation for each of these exercises, which includes the written portion of the exercise and corresponding instructions, is available on the StarGenetics website at star.mit.edu/genetics/problem-sets. Click on the desired exercise within this window to open it. To open an exercise that your instructor provided, go to File, Open, and select the appropriate file already downloaded onto your computer. I'm opening an exercise called Fruit Fly Video Exercise. If you are in an MIT course, students may be assigned different variations of the same exercise. When you open one of these exercises, you'll be prompted to enter your MIT email address. When you do so, you will be assigned a unique ID number. Write down this unique ID number for later reference. When submitting your responses to exercises for grading, you will need to include your unique ID number, which is used by the grader to identify which variation of the exercises you have been assigned. If you forget your ID number, you can find it in the title bar at the top of the StarGenetics window. You are now ready to start your experiments in StarGenetics.